afternoon everyone. Today I will guide you on how we configuring LAMP stack or Linux Nginx MySQL and PHP FPM on Ubuntu 18.04 LTS server. For testing purpose, we can use the CHIP 5 USD cloud server on DigitalOcean. So if you currently hosted your website on shared hosting, maybe you can consider to migrate it to VPS or cloud server. Then I will get you or advise you in configuring LAMP stack with FastCGI keys. Okay, let me create Droplet. Make sure to select Ubuntu LTS server if you want to get long-term support, and don't never use the non-LTS server. Send the support, it's only 1 year, like Ubuntu 20.01 and Ubuntu 90.01 and all the. Okay, I will stick on New York One data center. Then you can enable monitoring and IPv6. Later we will install WordPress for testing how FastCGI keys working on the site. Okay, let's create Droplet. So FastCGI keys can mostly improve your site loading, and it reduce server resource including memory and CPU consumption. So even if you using the cheap cloud server like 5 USD on DigitalOcean or maybe Vulture or Linode, the server consumption still server consumption different rather than if you using the control panel like cPanel WHM or Plex panel. So this configuration is intended for CLI-based server only and no GUI at all. So you will get only SSH terminal like this and SFTP client like PuTTY or like FileZilla or WinSCP FastCGI keys. So we can googling for this info. So what I know from as I know, FastGG cache is they will actively directive for caching dynamic content from PHP backend. So the back it's maybe like varnish cache, but for WordPress it can be configured with Nginx and PHP FPM. So if you have plan to using the varnish cache, they will work only for Apache HTTPD web server for backend with PHP FPM, while Nginx will act as reverse proxy in front of the Apache. So you cannot configure varnish cache with FastGG cache, then they will break your server configuration or conflict. So you can, from my perspective, we should choose one of them. If you plan to using varnish, you cannot using FastGG cache. Okay. Previously, I have create video on Indonesian language, so let me create on international English language. So I more prefer to using Nginx rather than Apache web server, or maybe Lightspeed Enterprise web server, since the Nginx is open source and free, and also can handle big traffic set or busy server, and of course it can handle more concurrent connection rather than using Apache web server. I don't hate Apache, but for performance reason I mostly depend on Nginx, and they can act as reverse proxy as well. Okay, let's login to SSH terminal. Since I'm using Debian based system, I can using GNOME terminal. If you Windows or Mac user, you can using PuTTY SSH client. Okay, press yes, then paste the password. Okay, after that run system update. Then apt upgrade. Okay, press Y. Make sure you run system update if you newly created the or new order the VPS or cloud server. So you will get the latest packet or software, and also Linux kernel and other dependency. Okay, don't forget to reboot the server after updating the system. Then wait maybe around 1 minute. Okay, after that re-login to the server. This Then simply install Nginx. But for this learning purpose, we can using the personal packet archive or PPA, which maintained actively and by Nginx official team. I will add the PPA for Nginx development or mainline branch. Then run apt update. So we will install the Nginx mainline branch. So they will bring the have more feature, and from my perspective it's more stable rather than Nginx stable itself, and update and feature it's more advanced on Nginx mainline branch. Okay, after that simply adding personal packet archive or PPA from Ondriji Suri like this, then press enter. Then run system update once again. So after that, I will install PHP 7.4. Press Y. Okay, I will point the my hostname of or subdomain to my server IP for address, so we can access it on public. Both a record and name or www record. Okay. Done. Then we can configure MySQL database server for DBMS system. Okay, add install MySQL server. Apt install MySQL server. We will install MySQL 5.7 on this virtual machine. After that, we can verify the MySQL version. So the installed MySQL version is 5.7.33 for Linux x86-64 using Edit-Land Wrapper. Then let's secure the MySQL installation, MySQL server, using MySQL secure installation command, and then press no. So we can set the correct root password. Make sure you create different password, one for your VPS root password or cloud server root password, and the one again for your database root password. Remove anonymous user, yes. Disallow root login remotely, yes. Then remove test database and access to it, yes. Then reload prefix table, no. Yay. All done. From this step, we can continue to create directory for subdomain or fastjgi. I use fastjgi knot35.com. Then enter the public directory. Then let's install WordPress. You can download from the official WordPress repository. Then extract the file. After that, make sure to set the correct ownership for both for user and group. We saw using the www data for user and www data for group. That shall be done on Debian Ubuntu LTS server. Then copy the default Nginx configuration. File back. Then remove the current configuration. Then create new one. Okay. We shall using the different configuration for Nginx with fastjgi case. It's different with a standard or pure Nginx configuration like this. Please note for micro case variable, you can rename it with another variable name like this. I will replace it with fastjgi case with fastjgi case name, and simply rising or increase the memory limit to this. You can set it if you have a dedicated server. Maybe you can set it to 1 GB or maybe 2 GB, so the memory or RAM consumption will be specially applied for the fastjgi case. Okay, like this. Then for worker process, you can set it to auto. So the core process will be auto increasing as you have more CPU core. So it will be automatically adjustable if your server have more CPU core. Then press F, Control O, Control X, then check the we can test the Nginx configuration to check if any error. Okay, we can the that create the directory. Can create a fastjg cache directory. Let's check the configuration nginx. Let's restart the service. Service nginx restart. After that, we can create the server block or virtual host. But on Nginx, virtual host is commonly known as server block. However, on Apache, it's known as virtual host or vhost. Then edit like this for configuration. Sorry, press no. Okay, paste and save. Control O, then Control X for exit. Then simply create database and its user for WordPress, so we can install WordPress on this subdomain. Like this. Then exit. Okay, from this step we can continue to sibling the server block into from set available directory into set enable directory. Also for error log and access log. Okay, let's test the configuration. Syntax is okay and test is successful. After that we can restart the web service, service nginx restart. Then after that we can edit the make sure to edit etc php 7.4 fpm poll d www.config. So we shall edit the this directive, especially listen directive. Listen directive. Sorry, server is stuck. Okay. Press no. No ATC PHP 7.4 fpm pull d www config. So let's edit the variable for listen socket. We shall change from the TCP, sorry, I mean from the Yes, I mean from Unix socket connection into TCP IP socket. So maybe from my perspective, the Unix socket is slightly faster, but is less scalable. So let's change to Unix socket or so TCP IP connection. Using localhost and this port. Okay, let's save. Make sure it's same as with server block. Then let's restart the PHP 7.4 FPM service. PHP 7.4 FPM restart or system CTL restart PHP 7.4 FPM service. After that, we can open the web browser, and I will open my subdomain. Like this. Okay, we enter the WordPress installation directory. So there are at least three variable if for server response header. If the FastJGE cache working properly, you will get the response header hit. Then while for bypass, it's indicated that FastJGE cache is ignored, especially on administrator area or admin area. Then if you see miss response header, that's indicated that FastJGE cache not working or not yet case. Okay, my blog username main password cvd19 dan submit. Sorry, we need to input the correct variable for database. Then run the installation. Then let's install WordPress. From this step, we can login the WP admin or dashboard admin area. Okay, ramain. So don't forget to install Nginx Helper plugin. So this this plugin is created by the developer, by the RTKM developer for purging FastDK cache module. So the team at RTKM using this plugin especially for plugin for purging or remove the cache. Then we can enter the directory for cd for www.fastjge.knot35.com public. Then let's edit the wp config php nano wp config php. Make sure you adding this variable. So this variable shall be adding right before that I'll stop editing happy publishing. Then press Ctrl O, Ctrl X, and then after that don't forget to check the user ownership. Sorry, I mean let's enter the directory for www.fastjge.knot.public. Then make sure to change the permission from file permission, yes, from 666 to 644. This is standard for standard permission for WordPress based CMS. So maybe you can set it to 444 if you need, but it cannot access it via the plugin to edit. So if you have more security reason, you can edit it to 444 like this or like this. So for this testing learning purpose, I will set it to default standard word BP to 6.644. Okay, let's setting the link helper plugin. Simply enable Parjo and then Nginx FastCG Cache and make sure to select delete local cache file. You instead using get request to Parjo URL. This is default option. So we should choose the delete local server charge file. Then save all change. Bypass. You will. Sorry. You will three response header as I can see previously, like bypass, which indicated that FastCG cache ignored the packs, and then if you get hit response code, it mean the FastCG cache is working properly. But if you found the FastCG cache miss, response code miss, that is indicated that the FastCG cache is not yet cache. The FastCG cache not yet cache. So simply reload. Hello world. So yun category set. Maybe this tutorial is with enough. We can continue on the next video so I can share more tutorial for you, and thank you so much and see you again. Good night.